Hello everybody, welcome back, Scratch Fofana, and today we are back in Eclipse here, working a little bit more on our furnace. Now, people have asked me, and I said I was going to go through, how you can create your very own multi-block structure. So, in this video I'm going to explain how you can create your very own multi-block structure. First of all, let's run Minecraft here, and let's kind of define and create our multi-block structure. Okay, because that's basically, first of all, that's what you want to know. How do you want your multi-block structure to look? So that's basically what we're going to do here. Now, it says launching client here. It's probably doing a little bit of other stuff in the background. There we go. Now it's opened up and it shouldn't take too long. I do have my deck up here. Now, let's go into a single player world. Oh, that's a lot of world. Let's just open this one. And yeah, that's that world. We're seeing a little bit of lag here, but who cares about my lag? Now we have our furnace here. Let's go another place. Okay, let's just do it here. So we got a furnace, right? We can right-click our furnace, and it opens up. Now. What if we want a multi-block structure, okay? What if we want this to only be able to open up, that we can only open it up when it looks like a certain type, like a certain multi-block structure? So, now, of course I might split this into two parts, but yeah, mainly one part, hopefully. Now, first of all, we want to create our multi-block structure. Now, let's, I'm going to use a few weird stuff. Now, for now, you cannot use, you can basically not use these kind of, you can basically not use metadatas in your multi-block structures, and we'll, or I think we'll use multi-block structures, let's turn on here, we'll use this metadata. So you can basically not use, you cannot figure out metadata. So you know all of these, it wouldn't care which type of rule you are selecting. Now it does not care which way you place it either. You know, that's some other different kind of stuff. But I of course will update it. Now let's try our best here. To create a nice multi-block structure. Oh. Let's go for something like... I'm very bad at building stuff, just so you know. And of course this video is not about building, but we want a multi-block structure, and a multi-block structure we will get. And let's do something like that. Now, how big do we want our multi-block structure to be? Currently, you can only have a 9x9. I've set that cap because the colors look a little bit weird. No, sorry, the text look a little bit weird. Now, let's have a few more cool blocks here. I want you to have a crafting table here, here. And in the middle, you want a diamond block. Search up diamond block, and then you want another crafting table here. Now, of course, you can access the crafting tables. Now, the way to fix this is basically just to create a new block with the same textures as a crafting table, and when this basically triggers true, you create this block into a Mudueki. And when you break any of these blocks around it, you know, it will update, and voila, it's no longer a multi-block structure. So yeah. Now, we are not finished yet, sorry. Just had a little bit of a pause there. What else to build, what else to add? Let's do a hopper, I think. Not sure what to add. Oh, anvils, slightly. Let's search for anvil. Oh, spacebar. There we go, anvil. Let's place that one in the middle. Let's do a few animals at the side. Let's make all of face. You know, you cannot detect the direction these blocks face. But yeah, there you go. That's a multi-block structure enough for me. So now you can still access your quartz furnace, and when you burn anything, it will still burn. Now that's basically what we're going to remove. So that it needs to look exactly like this. It doesn't matter the direction, basically, but you know, as long as, you know, in any type of direction, it looks something like this. Now, what you basically want to do is you want to stand at the front of this, usually where your Maduheki is. It doesn't matter where you say the front is. If I want to, this to be the front, it does not matter at all. People will, when playing, look at this as the front, and you know, no damage is taken. It will just check, you know, the block there. You know, a little bit different checking, no more lag, and anything like that. I'm not sure if this actually creates lag. But yeah, this is basically what we're going for. The anvil, you know, it doesn't matter where you place the anvils, and the hopper, it doesn't matter where you place the hoppers, and it doesn't matter if you take it up or down these slabs, I believe. Or which type of slab, actually. But yeah, who cares? Now, this is a program. We're going to use a program. It's very simple to do this without a program, just add some, you know, a little bit more extra code. But for those who do not wish to spend hours, this is a very great way to do it. So, let's open up my program. It can be downloaded at scratch4fun.net. There will be a link in the description. Down in the description it says contacts, I think, or website, I'm not sure. And you just click my website, scratch4fun.net, and under the download section, the first link should be my Minecraft modding developer. And now it's currently in version 0.003b. Now you can't see, you know, down here, because you know, it's not capturing it that low. But yeah, it's still getting worked on. I've done a little bit more in GUI programming, which I want to add. Now, how does this work, this program? Well, what you basically want to think first is your bottom layer. So let's rebuild the bottom layer here. Now, of course, you do not need to do all of this crap. As long as you basically know how it is going to look. Let's grab that block there. So, diamond block in the middle, and we want crafting tables at each side. So this is basically layer one. Now, what you want to do is you want to open up your Minecraft modding developer, go in under the multi-block structure tab here. This only works for Windows, I believe, sorry. Now, if you are on Linux, you can use some commands, I believe, to run exe files. So yeah, just search it up. Might make a Mac and Linux, you know, support in the future. But I'm not working, you know, too much on the program itself. I'm more working behind the GUI for now, at least. So yeah, it might come in the future, of course. So, first of all, what you want to make sure is that your Minecraft modding developer stands on multi-block structure, and that it says current layer equals 1, okay? We are building layer number 1. Layer number 1 is the bottom layer, basically, okay? And then we want to select the width, the height, and the depth, okay? Now, first of all, make sure that this is in, that this is not a, in a kind of, in a, oh, what's the word I'm looking for? In a drive. I think in a different drive. Now I'm not sure how that works, because this right here is a drive I've plugged in myself, so I'm not sure the difference between these two right here. Hopefully I did not open anything. Probably did. No, I didn't. But yeah, this basically came with the computer. Now you will basically have to make sure that your program stands on the C drive. That's your safest bet for creating, because we're basically going to generate a little bit of code here. So the width, the height, and the depth of your entire structure. So what you basically do is you count 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's the width. The width is basically how wide it is from the front here. So we're going to set width equal to 3. That's the default. The depth is basically how far it is behind here. So 1. and then 2, and then 3. Okay, so 3 in depth. Let's make sure. Yes, we do have 3 in depth here. Now 3 in height as well is important. Let's check here. We had 1, 2, 3. If your structure is, for example, looking something like this, you know, here it's 5 wide. Now, this basically goes for the entire structure. So these blocks right here will count. You know, that block, all of these blocks will count. So all of these blocks will count. Now the width is still 5 by 3 by and then 3 far. So yeah, just you know, it's important that you know the kind of dimensions of your multi-block structure. That's usually why you build it on forehand. And I got a fly on my computer screen here. But yeah, now our is going to be a 3 by 3 by 3, and that's what we've done so far. Now, each time you change any of these 6 settings up here, width, height, depth, offset, or any of the offsets basically, all of the numbers and block IDs will get reset. So this is basically a starting stuff, okay? Now, it says main here, and we still got some offset variables to set. Now, what is that? That is basically looking from down, you know, at the front left. This, you know, this kind of wood block, trying to get far enough away. This wood block down here is basically the main block right now. This is basically the block you right-click. Now, that is not the block we right-click. We right-click the furnace, so it's basically one more in X. Now, it doesn't matter the coordinates, but, you know, kind of X is that way, Z is that way, and Y is up, just so you know that. So yeah, if you look from the top, basically, on layer 1, and you think that... How do you do this again? I'm not sure. But yeah, you think that this is basically 0, 0 in offset, and if I want to, I want to offset it by 1 in the X. Looked from above, we got this GUI right here. Basically, it says main here. What I can do is I can basically experiment a little bit. I want to offset the X by 1, and that moves the main over to here. So from the top, the main is at the middle, kind of. Middle down is looked from above, and here as well, our main block is middle down, looked from the front. Okay, very important. And there we go. We've now set the offset. Now you can also, of course, offset the set if I want the block I right click to be in the middle. It's basically going to stand basically here. Now. Of course, you can also go up in set as well, in Y as well. If I set this to 1, it disappears from my screen. That basically means that you need to move up layer. Okay, so now at layer 2, layer 2 is basically the second layer here, the one at eye height. So yeah, just use the offsets, very, very simple. Use them, you know, kind of cool. No. But yeah, so when let's just move down again to offset 0. That basically means that we need to move up to layer 1. Now, the height is very important. You cannot move above the height, so I cannot be at layer 4. There's nothing on my screen because there is no layer 4. So yeah. Now, let's get down to layer 0 again. So, here we are. This is our screen. Now, we need to set the block IDs of all of these blocks. So a good idea is basically to hit F3H, basically just F3 and then plus H. There you go, just click this, or click F3 and then click H at the same time, voila, not in text mode as I think, and you should get the block IDs on screen. So let's start with layer 0, make sure you are at layer 0, hopefully I'm explaining this good enough, hopefully I'm not over-explaining anything. So yeah, we are at layer 1, I mean, sorry. Now, let's go to the top left right here. We want to set the block ID. Now, the top left is basically this wooden block right here. Now, we need to set, what is the block ID for this wooden block? It is 17. So let's go in here, let's make sure this block is selected, make sure we are at layer 1. make sure we get all of these settings basically done. If you change any of these settings, all of your block IDs will get reset. So current block ID is equal to 0. Nope. I want this to be equal to 17 because, you know, the wooden block right here, which we're using, is 17. Now all of the wooden blocks have the same ID. So you can basically use any of these wooden kind of blocks for your structure. Now, of course, I'm going to upgrade the program a little bit in the future. But yeah, now let's move on. The crafting table here is the second block, basically looked from above this block right here. If I'm not very much mistaken, it's 45, and I am very much mistaken, it is 58, and then you basically just fill out. So 58 here as well, we get some crafting tables at the these three right here. Now you can set a multi-block, you can set a block ID for your main block as well, but it doesn't matter what I set the block ID here to be. Now here I got logs as well, log and another log. The middle block is a diamond, a block of diamond, which is 57. So let's set this to 57. There you go. That's the first layer done. We got our main block here and all of these other blocks. Let's move up to layer 2. Now, how does layer 2 look? Let's build up layer 2 here. There you go. Once more, these slab kind of thingies. And then we got a hopper. And I did not meant to do that. Hopper. There you go. So a kind of this block in the middle here, okay? Now, let's do this once again. All the corners are 17 because that's block ID for logs. Let's move in here. The corners are 17. 17. 17 and 17. Current layer is equal to 2, make sure that is correct. And then we got slabs at all of these. And slabs are 44. So let's just make sure that all of... What's just got reset? What just happened here? I'll be back when I got this up. Okay, so all of these are finished here. It doesn't matter if it's a 0 at the front here, basically. But yeah, I've gotten all of these block IDs up again. I'm not sure what happened. But yeah, now we are at layer 2. I've set these to be slabs, 44, and then 17, which is logs. And here you go. And then you got leaves, which is 18. Why does it get reset every single time? But yeah, make sure you do not do that. Probably do not close it. Okay, so leaves are 18, layer 2 here. I'm not sure why this is bugged out, but I'll do my best to create a fix for it. So yeah. Now 18 is in the middle here, which is leaves. Let's do not click this tab right here. And then it's the final level, we can have a look over here. We get anvil, which is 145 at each corner. So layer 3, 145 on all of these. There we go. And there. And then we basically want this hopper in the middle here, which is 154. So there you go. That's basically all of your that's basically your multi-block structure coded into the program. Now we are still missing some stuff. And what are we missing? Well, these are currently set to 0. Okay, what does this mean? Well, if you set this to 0, it basically says okay, this has to be a air block. So it will not work if I place this block right here. That's not a air block. So if it's at 0, it needs to be a air block. Now, if it is not at 0, if you leave it at a negative value, if I leave this at minus, for example, 1, it will treat it as a block that's not existing. So this block right here, it doesn't matter what type of block is here. Okay? Doesn't matter at all. So yeah. Now, I do matter. I want all of this to be air around it. You know, I want it to be air. All of these blocks has to be air. Now, then what I can do is I can make sure to leave this as zero if you want them to be error. Let's just double check. Okay, I got everything correct. I hit the generate code tab. Now, the place where you leave your Minecraft modding developer, in my case the desktop, it will basically create a new file called file.txt. So if I open up this file, you can see I got all of this code right here. Now that's basically all a very lot of code. You know, if you were not using this program, you would basically had to write all of that code yourself. So that's why you use a program created by Scratchfan, by me basically. Programmed it myself. So yeah, hopefully you use it. It's totally free, nothing at all, no charges, nothing. Just to help you out basically. So yeah, now the hard thing is not to write all of this. Of course, you know, it takes time to write all of this. The hard thing is basically to get all of these numbers right, and you know, basically, you know, that's the hard thing. So it's basically testing all the blocks and make sure that they are equal to what it's supposed to be. So let's click Control A to copy all of this, Control C to copy. Let's jump into our thingy right here. Let's close that off. We got our code. Let's jump down to our tile entity. Let's not do the tile entity now. Let's go into the block class, okay? So in under blocks, now block quartz furnace or your furnace block, all you basically need to do is you need to copy or basically paste the code from this txt file down here. So let's make a little bit of space for it, and let's paste all of this code in. Now it does not leave you with any errors at all. It should not, at least, or unless you have not copied the entire code. And now it's all on one line. How do I fix this? Well, what you do is you basically select this line right here. Now you do not need to select it, but if you do not select it, or you know, the entire screen will basically change. So what I do is I select this line to basically make sure that only change this line right here, and then hit Control F, I think. I'm not exactly sure, or Control Shift F. Let's try Control F. Nope. It was not Control F. Let's try Control Shift F, and there you go. It basically kind of opened up. Now, after a width, you know, a certain kind of width here, it'll start to break up. Okay, now you can change that in the code, you know, in Eclipse somewhere, but I'm not exactly sure where. Now, this would happen to all of your other code as well, if you selected everything. So it's basically going to get cut here. You know, it's still working code, it just looks a little bit weird. So yeah, I'm basically, what's the word I'm looking for? Is it you I'm looking for? But yeah, it generates five methods, I believe. Five methods. It checks four methods are checking the directions, and the final one is basically a boolean. Is this a multi-block structure? Then it checks all the directions. It generates code for all the direction, basically, all the directions. Now, what we basically want to do is we want to copy this right here, this method name and arguments. Now, whenever I hit on block activate, I basically want to say, you know, oh snap, I copied that line right there. Let's get down again. Copy is multi-block structure and the arguments, and let's get up again. It's getting a little bit long now, actually. So in block, now we are here checking some stuff. Sorry about that, got interrupted. But we are here checking, basically we are checking that we are in a server. That you're basically opening this as a server. Now what we also want to check is we want to basically check, is this a multi-block structure? So what we do is we basically copy that, hit save, and errors should be gone. Now you do not, or you cannot have this initializer kind of thing here at the front, because we're not creating a new variable. So world x, y, and z, that's basically all you need to check if this is a multi-block structure or not of your type. So there you go. It should only activate. You should only be able to right click if it looks exactly like it does. So let's test this out. Hopefully it works. hopefully my code is coded correctly. Yeah. This is our multi-block structure right here. Now, first of all, a normal furnace. Are we able to open it? No. I right-click this furnace, nothing happens. Here as well, nothing happens at all. But this, okay, so this is basically the real test. Can I right-click it? Yes, I can. It still works like a normal furnace. And it still cooks and everything like that. But if I break one single block like a anvil, I can no longer right-click it, basically. Now, it doesn't matter, where I place this anvil. Let's turn that off. It doesn't matter where I place the anvil or what type of wood this is. It does. It does. This is weird. No, it doesn't. What? Maybe a little bit of lag, I'm not sure. But yeah, it doesn't matter what type of... time set 2000, I guess. So it doesn't matter what type of wood you use or whichever direction you choose to place your wood for now, because it's not tracking metadata. Now, in code, you are very much able to do that stuff. Now, for the sake of this video, I'll do my best and hopefully manage to update that source code in hopefully a week. I do have a lot of other stuff to do, so yeah, I'm not sure if I will make it or not, but I'll do my best to update the source code. Now, of course, this can be right-clicked from any angle at any angle at your basically of your choosing. I'm not sure how you say that, but yeah, here you go. Let's create this multi-block structure here from this angle as well. Leave there, and let's place the crafting tables, and let's place the anvils and the hopper. It doesn't matter what type of leave you have, and since the anvils are using basically metadata, it does not matter. But once again, I will hopefully get back to that. Did we do anything wrong here? Yes, we placed these in the wrong spot. These are supposed to be in the corners. So that's why I am not able to right-click it. But now that they are basically placed at the right place, it does matter. Everything does matter. Now, even here, no longer a air block. It checks, and it basically checks that this is an air block. And this is no longer an air block. Now it is an air block. So yeah, now it works. So yeah, that's how to create your very own multi-block structure. Now, of course, we are not finished here. It will be another part or two, basically explaining, because right now I can basically start cooking a little bit of coal. Let's grab a little bit of coal here, and let's put in a little bit of wood. Now, if I break this, I cannot access it, but once I place it down again, it will basically open up jungle wood. And even if I break the block, the wood will, of course, pop out. And you will get an achievement. But yeah, now if I start this furnace cooking and then destroy a block, I cannot access it, but it is cooking. So if I wait a little bit here, it updated the anvil after a very long time. I can still not right click it, but once I basically place it down how it was basically, you can see that it's, it cooked in the meantime. Now, we need to make sure that when you destroy any of these blocks, it will stop cooking, and all of that dandy, handy, super duper work. I believe it's one more episode. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Multi-block structure, here we go. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, everybody. My name is Crashfan, and I'll catch you all guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.